But I think on the civil society side, the concerns are more foundational and more fundamental. Is this just pie in the sky? Are we being promised something that will not materialize, and therefore this is a distraction from the work that needs to happen? And even if direct air capture turns out to be a thing, is it a thing at the cost of other things? So that is, should we be putting attention onto direct air capture when there's more urgent and immediate and clearly defined work that could be done right now? So I think that's the civil society message, which boils down to don't let direct air capture and other forms of carbon removal distract from emissions abatement, distract from trying to prevent greenhouse gases from getting into the atmosphere right now. Okay, so that's a very real and reasonable concern. And at the same time, I think what Jen said is absolutely right. We need to think of doing things together. This is not an either-or conversation. It's an and conversation. So are there ways that direct air capture is compatible with the energy and other forms of revolution that we need to wean society off fossil fuels? What do those pathways look like?
Right.
And that's an act of imagination, and it's an act of coalition building, in addition to an act of kind of technical wondrousness to make that happen.